guy who's been around the best, Jerry. When I mean the best,
he's excited.
Yeah, he's excellent. And Barry, why don't you tell our listeners if they want to get a hold of you to learn the game a little bit? How would they get in touch with you?
Oh gosh, if anybody wants to get a hold of me, I guess the best way they can I'll just give you my golf course number is 954-796-7506. That's a direct number to me, and just have fun with it, Jerry. And you got a good teacher in Jess, and Jess is a pleasure. Anytime I can help you with something, you let me know.
Oh, Barry, there's few like you, sir, and I really appreciate your time.
And you already helped us by sharing your knowledge with all of our listeners, so thank you so much for that.
Thank you so much for coming on, Barry.
All right.
My pleasure, guys. Have a good evening.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Cinderella story, out of nowhere, a former grangekeeper now about to become the Masters champion.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole!
Young love can teach us bite. Cheeks flushed, apple red. Ringing you every day. Begging for a word of grace. Put aside the foolish games. A run and hide of all the names. School's out, bells will ring.
And we are back, and what an appropriate song for a day where we have two great teachers giving some tips to everybody. And, of course, the one that's right here that is available for Jerry to help her on a daily basis is my good friend Jess Frank from the Jess Frank Golf Academy, which, of course, is the home of the playing lesson. And Jess Frank, who for 15 years has been improving golfers' ball striking, consistency, and distance, he's a PGA teaching professional, owner of the Jess Frank Golf Academy, which is located in Boca Raton at the beautiful Boca Dunes Golf and Country Club. So if you're a seasoned golfer who's trying to break 80, or a beginner like Jerry, Jess's passion is to help you play better golf and have a lot of fun while doing it. Each lesson includes on-course time with V1 video analysis, focusing on improving all facets of your game. And for a limited time, new students who mention the Golf and Travel Show, when you arrange for your first four lessons, you're going to get a 50% discount. It's typically a $400 value, but you're only going to be charged $200 for that package. So just mention the Golf and Travel Show. And to learn more about the services of the Jess Frank Golf Academy, you can give them a call at 561-213-8579. That's 561-213-8579, or just visit jessfrankgolf.com. And when I hear that music, which is, of course, called Traveling Shoes by Elvin Bishop, it reminds me that Jerry's got some travel talk that and some wonderful information and some great guests to tell you a little bit about some places to go, things to do, fun to have, and going to turn it over to you, Jerry, to introduce our next guest.
Okay. Thanks, Dan and Jess. Tonight, our first guest I'm pleased to have is Jennifer Fernandez, and she's the Director of Events for the Travel Show Marketing Group. Jennifer has over 20 years' experience in the travel industry. She has an extensive background in producing highly effective travel trade shows and events. She touches on every aspect of sales, marketing, content, and engagement to assist travel professionals like myself to experience and educate us on incredible destinations. She has previously worked for major trade show companies, including Miller Friedman, Advanstar, and Questex, where she was responsible for the entire leisure program travel events portfolio. Welcome, Jennifer.
So much for having me.
How are you? And how's the weather in New York?
So today is a beautiful day, very different from the polar vortex that we were experiencing about a week ago.
I know. I was up there for the holidays, and it was. I got out just in time before it was unreal. Definitely.
It was brutal. Yeah. So we're experiencing a nice break. I think it'll get cold again, but that's New York.
Definitely. So tell us a little bit about the specialty travel forums and what's coming up and pretty much what they're all about. And usually what we have guests that are at one resort, but I know that you know a lot about many and you share that with all of us. So give us a little aspect of the whole picture, how it works.
Great. Well, my company is Travel Show Marketing Group, and we have a division called Specialty Travel Forums. And basically what our commitment is we serve the travel agent community. We serve the travel trade, I should say, because we engage suppliers with travel agents so that they're aware of everything that's out there. We offer basically classroom training, which is so important, and that would go from destination training, product training, business training. They're all designed to help travel agents maintain and grow a profitable travel agency business model. And we work with a number of associations and consortia to kind of put these things together. So the event that we have coming up in May specifically is the Romance Travel Forum, because we believe it's very important to teach travel agents basically how to progress in a specific niche. And romance is a huge market right now. So we'll have that classroom training, but because we're bringing the event to Mexico, Cancun specifically, we'll collaborate with the different supplier partners, and we'll take the travel agents throughout the destinations. They could do some site visits at area properties. They could, you know, basically check out a destination and experience it the way their client would experience it. So it's exciting to have that opportunity so that when they're booking travel for their clients, they're maintaining, I should say they're exceeding those expectations.
So let me ask you, it's going to be at the Paradisus Resort. Have you stayed there previously?
I have. It's a beautiful property. It's part of the Melia Hotel family, which is basically a recognized name in all-inclusive hospitality. It's an all-inclusive luxury resort. It's the perfect property for families, for a dream honeymoon or destination wedding or any celebratory event. It's beautiful. It's right on the beach. It has about 9 restaurants, a beautiful spa facility. It's got an adults, a royal section, so that it's adults only. So no matter what you're going for, there's something for the end user, the consumer.
Dan liked the portion when you said adults only. He liked that.
Yeah. Thanks, Jennifer, for that. But unfortunately, I've spent enough years traveling with children, my own and other people's, and I think I've had enough of that. So, but I think my wife and maybe Jess's girlfriend is listening too. So I think we're going to get roped into a vacation like any moment now. So just keep talking, and we'll just open up our wallets. So
even the airlines are starting to cater to the quiet zones. You know, so if you're
wow.
get away and fly and. They're going to charge you a premium, of course.
Of course. But it's worth every penny, right?
So not only charging for seats, but charging to be in a quiet seat. Is that the new thing
now? That's exactly right, yes. So hopefully it'll come with more legroom as well.
It's probably, though, like back in the old days when they allowed smoking on the plane, you'd be in the non-smoking section, and it was the row right behind the smoking section. And it was like, well, this isn't really doing all that much, so it's probably
it's
the same.
Shields, yes.
So how many, at this first event in May, how many do you expect?
We expect about 250 travel agents, and the agents that are coming are being hand-selected because we want to make certain that the agents are there. It's the niche. It's the romance niche. It's very profitable, but we want to make certain that the agents that are coming are truly interested in romance. They want to build their business as a destination wedding specialist, honeymoons. There's so many different trends now in the marketplace that kind of derive from the romance market. So you've got baby moons, you know, people that are going on that vacation. They're just pregnant. Mini moons for the couples that have to get away really quick, or you know, for a honeymoon, but they've only got a short amount of time. Anniversaries, of course, vow renewals. I mean, there's so many opportunities, and we kind of plan on touching on all of that. And we'll have about 75 suppliers on hand. We will have a lot of Mexico and Caribbean representation, but we're getting a lot of interest from suppliers outside of those regions. I know that we're talking to Greece, within the Caribbean. I should say we have. Representation from Jamaica, Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, the Bahamas, there's so many wonderful destinations that we'll have represented at the event.
Wait, wait, I smell something. I think it's love. Love is in the air.
Those are some nice golf destinations, too, there, Jennifer.
They are.
Yes.
Fabulous golf destinations, absolutely. We're hoping to get some Hawaii also because it's an amazing golf destination, but it's a great... A lot of these destinations cater to many different travelers, but these are the trends right now that they're focusing on.
So this is a big investment on your company.
Yeah.
So obviously... How do the bookings come in? Do a lot of bookings then come from us as agents? Because it seems to me that more people are going to us now than looking on the internet for that romantic vacation.
Well, I think also with a romantic vacation, I mean, it's perhaps a once-in-a-lifetime experience. So it's not something that you'll trust to an online booking agent, you know, like one of the online vendors. So I think that travel agents, consumers are seeing a true value with travel agents. You know, something happens. There's a lot of things going on in the world. I know I was in Europe when the volcano in Iceland was starting to erupt, and you're stuck there. So if you work with a travel agent, you have that person to kind of go through, whether you want that upgrade. And that's also something that travel agents can offer if they're booking a lot with a property. If they have these great relationships that they've developed, they can call someone. If they can get that suite that you want. It's just something, it's one of the benefits that a consumer can take advantage of by working with a travel professional.
Absolutely, and I love to experience it before I send someone. I usually, if I haven't been able to actually attend, go there and enjoy it, then attend
a
webinar or a class or things that you're doing as well. When's the next one? How many do you plan to do? I'm sorry, how many a year do you plan?
Well, for the specialty travel forums, because we want to make sure that we have that destination immersion. So for Mexico, for instance, to that point before, Jerry, we'll be taking the travel agents not only to the Paradisus, but we're going to be taking them around Cancun. They'll be able to visit with brands such as Palace Resorts, the Moon Palace, the Rio property, Sandos, Secrets of the Vine, which is AM Resorts property,
right,
and Hard Rock Cancun, which is a completely different product than any of the other ones that I mentioned. So it's very important that a travel agent understands and can match the personality of their client with the type of property or destination that they're booking them to. So our plan is to move forward with anywhere between 2 and 3 of these a year, focus on different niches. Romance is one of them. We're seeing a lot of trends come. There's a lot of multi-generational type of vacations, family travel, which you will clearly be going on shortly. Adventure travel is a big one. And I know that American Express just recently put out some feedback that rail travel, solo travel, I mean, there's so many different niches that are hot right now, but we'll be focusing on romance right now as one area for travel agents to make some money from.
I wonder if, like, a year later, if you get to, like, meet the children that were conceived on these trips, that would be pretty cool.
We could do some type of prize for that or something. Put the dates down, and that'd be kind of fun to do that. I'll note that down for you. And so basically, my other question is, while they're there, how long is it? 4 days?
They'll be there for 4 days, and we're working also with the tourism board from the Riviera Maya, which is
right
next to Cancun. So we're going to be offering some post-show familiarization opportunities for a limited number of travel agents. The Riviera Maya has been kind enough to extend their hospitality and host the travel agents for that portion, and they'll have the opportunity to stay at some properties. Riviera Maya is a very luxury destination. Some great products. Grand Velas is out there, one of my favorite properties. You've got the Fairmont, you've got so many different properties.
The Grand Princess, I've sent several people out that way, so they've really enjoyed it. They come back so happy.
Beautiful, and it's very different than Cancun, which is amazing considering how close they are, but it's a different product. And again, that's why we feel that this is a smart investment on our company's part, because travel agents need to understand the difference between the different destinations and what each destination offers culturally, from accommodations, activities, not one size does not fit all.
Definitely not. You've done a terrific job for us. Thank you so much. One quick question. What is your favorite destination in Mexico that you enjoy?
My favorite destination is probably the Riviera Maya, but it's a close tie with Puerto Vallarta. I love Puerto Vallarta. It's a different vibe.
Me too. I love it there too.
A lot of culture. It's safe. It's friendly. You can move around. There's so much to do. There's so much to see. And the food is fantastic. It's basically everything you ask for a vacation.
Well, sounds wonderful. Well, I hope to see you very soon, and I appreciate you being on our show, and I'd love to have you come back after the event so that we can hear all about it.
That would be great. Thank you so much. I appreciate this.
Thanks, Jennifer.
Thanks, Jennifer.
Take care.
Have a good night.
We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back with a little bit more. And we are back, and it's my pleasure to tell you a little bit more about Sea Dreams Travel, which, of course, is the home of our own Jerry Augustine. And if you've been looking for that perfect vacation with the best value, and you're tired of searching the internet, or holding on some toll-free number, or trying to deal with an automated booking agent, well, that's just crazy, because at Sea Dreams, you can benefit from Jerry and her team's vast knowledge, buying power, protection, and added values that you just won't find on your own. All at no extra cost to you. A perfectly planned vacation, hassle-free, and filled with unforgettable moments. At Sea Dreams, you can find valuable offers that only a travel agency can provide, such as all-inclusives at 35 to 65% off, cruises where kids sail free, luxury villas all over the world, and vacations that start at as little as $199 per person. Sea Dreams is open 7 days a week, and for this week's specials, you can give Jerry a call at 561-310-9337. That's 561-310-9337, or visit SeaDreamsTravel.com. Sea Dreams Travel, your world, your way. And we are back, and we were hoping to get Jeff Adam to talk a little bit about Africa and Australia, but I guess he's way down under today, so I think now he was calling from, where is he in
Actually,
Africa?
Actually, he's in Vegas, so we may not know what happened to him.
Well.
I gave him $20 to put on red today, and the time difference.
Maybe he was using a payphone and used up his money in the casino or something.
You know, the time difference he was a little confused with, so we might be getting a call in an hour after we're...
Yeah, so you'll be listening to some other show and he'll be calling in.
That's
so,
right.
All right, but we'll try and reschedule him for another time, because I know that he has some interesting tales to tell.
It was exciting, because I actually heard a webinar with him today, and he was definitely a fun guy and full of information.
He's exhausted, I guess.
But, yeah, I guess so, but that's okay. So let's see, we'll talk about a little what's going on soon, and that's the Super Bowl. We can talk a little bit about the Super Bowl.
Well, I know we had already spoken, I guess it was Norwegian, who they've got the floating home for the Super Bowl, the home or hotel or whatever it is their ship.
All my clients have come out of the woodwork thinking I can get them a deal. I am so sorry. Bud Light chartered the ship, and there is no room for us. They're just, agents can't go, no one can go, and unless you, of course, have the big bucks and were invited.
Or if you probably won some sort of contest or promotion that Bud is doing, that's probably the other way. But I got news for you. That game, as much as I love the fact that it's where my team plays, I'm not so sure that in February it's the best place to be sitting out watching a football game, so... Wait until it comes to some place where there's a roof or some warmer weather, perhaps, and you'll be better off. And I'm sure you'd be able to accommodate people in the future.
Definitely. So,
a little advance notice, perhaps, right?
You know, one of the things, though, I did check today, and there are still tickets. So that's...
At a price, there's always tickets.
Always tickets. But one of the little hints is that the average hotel night, and there are some still available, it's about $500 a night.
Which is typical for any time in New York, right?
That's correct. But if you stay in the Bronx, about 15 miles away, it's $169.38 for a three-star decent spot to stay.
Nothing personal, but, you know.
just a little help. Take in the transit, that'll cost you $16.50. If you have two beers, that's $10, and some wings for $8.82. So you can do the whole thing for $204.70.
Not including
not
your ticket, though.
Tickets.
Yeah, exactly.
But that's what's going on there in New York. So I hope our teams win. What can I say?
Well, my team isn't playing, so they're not going to win. That's for sure.
My team's home.
Yeah. So.
Well, I have a couple of my teams that are still in there, being from Massachusetts, and then my cousin plays for San Francisco.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
very nice. All right. Well, you know what? We got the big screen TVs down here and the beautiful weather, and we'll watch it just fine.
A cousin that plays professional sports, Jerry. That's in the genes. Then you're going to have a pretty good career in golf.
I don't know what happened to me, but we'll see. Okay, and then some of the new things that are going on close to home here. Actually, the Four Seasons is going to open near Disney World.
Oh, nice.
So that is their first spot. And they're going to have a 5-acre playground.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm not going to be staying there then if they're catering to children, I guess. But now Four Seasons, I don't typically stay at a Four Seasons. And you know, when it comes to the higher-end hotel chains, I've stayed at their competitor, Ritz-Carlton, many times. Just coincidentally, it just works out that way. For a long time, Ritz-Carlton was known to be the number one rated, high-end luxury chain. But I think in the past several years, Four Seasons has been pretty much known to be the number one, right?
Well, it is. I would say it's close. It's close between the two of them.
And another
and
one
Saint
that
Regis is
I was just
really,
going to say, St. Regis, I've heard wonderful things too.
Yes, and I'm booking actually someone there very shortly, so that's what made me think about that.
If you want to have a romantic vacation, take your significant other to one of these places, and you're guaranteed having a good romantic vacation. I think that always seems to work, right?
Well, they're going to have 444 rooms for you to choose from and a wonderful spa. So I'm sure even if there's children around, you will be extremely happy.
Well, you let someone else take the kids to the theme park and you go to the spa. I think that's the answer right there.
There you go.
Now, what about golf? At the Ritz-Carlton, they do have a golf course. I don't know
about
the Four Seasons.
No, they're not planning golf on this particular one. I would definitely tell you, definitely.
Nice. Okay, but there is plenty of golf courses in the Orlando area. I'm going to be sampling one on Sunday, one on Monday, and one on Tuesday, so not too bad.
No.
Plenty of good golf in Orlando.
Well, and then my next little chat that we could talk a little about is in Port Canaveral at the cruise terminal, they are really going to be enlarging that tremendously. They're putting in over something that can actually hold over 6,000 passenger vessel. So they'll be able to really accommodate like Royal Caribbean's Oasis class. And it will be in 2016 that it's coming out.
Well, that'll be nice, because I know, other than the Disney lines that obviously they have a few boats out of there, the other cruise lines, typically, I think they're the older ships that are leaving out of there.
They
have some pretty good deals. They price them correctly, but if you're looking for a newer, more upscale kind of a boat, you're not going to find that yet. And Port Canaveral, at least for folks like where I live on the Treasure Coast, it's a little bit less congested and more convenient to get to. So if they upgrade the level of the lines that are or the boats that are leaving out of there, I think that would be a major plus for the area. It's good for the tourism, right?
Definitely so. And it's going to be a 185,000 square foot terminal. So it'll be very modern and one on the south side of the port. And they'll also have tenants in there. And it'll be a new $85 million terminal. So it's pretty cool.
Very nice. Very nice. So that's good news. And obviously there's a lot of other things to do pre- and post-cruise because, you do have Port Canaveral there, so you can get an opportunity to check that out as well. And Yeah, so it's nice to hear, and it's great for, our, like I say, our economy, both the tourism and the construction and everything else. But I think what we're going to do is we're going to quickly change our direction here because I do believe that we have our guests. So why don't you go ahead and make a quick introduction
okay.
so that we, because we only got a couple of minutes left.
Okay, I'm just going to introduce Jeff Adams. He is a destination specialist for Africa, Australia, New Zealand, and the islands of the South Pacific, and he's from Adelaide, Australia, and he moved here in 2000 before the Olympic Games to promote Australia and New Zealand, and I'm not going to say a lot about him because I know we do not have much time left. We're a little late, so I would just want to say welcome, Jeff.
Yeah, g'day there. Thank you very much, and I appreciate the opportunity to be on board and saying hello. I understand you, you're into, there's a bit of interest in golf in there. Is that true?
Absolutely.
Yes, we love it. So give us a quick tip on a great place to play that you can tell us about.
Well, I've got to say, if you're heading down under, right now, Australia, of course, for those watching television and probably watching the Australian Open, the Australian Tennis Open's on right now, well, that happens in Melbourne, Victoria. And if you're playing golf down there, some of the best golf courses in the world are found in that region. In fact, there's some great courses where you can play with kangaroos bouncing across the course and some really classic areas in which to get a good game, a good round of golf in.
Well, this morning I listened to you on Everything About Africa, and I thought, yep. Why don't you spend a few minutes telling us about that, like the Big Five? We only have 1 minute, so spend 1 minute telling us about the Big Five.
Well, Africa as a destination, of course, gives people the opportunity to go on safari. And with regards to safari, the experience of getting close to the wildlife is really what it's all about. Now, the Big Five can be found in certain areas of Africa, Kenya, definitely, Tanzania, parts of South Africa as well. And the Big Five, of course, we speak of are the lion, the leopard, the buffalo, the elephant, and the rhinoceros. And, of course, they're the Big Five because, of course, they used to be hunted. Now we hunt them with cameras. And I like the fact, even though it's really quite a horrific history in terms of them being hunted ruthlessly, but I think the fact they get good focus is also helping preserve them and giving people the opportunity to go out there and stay in a tented safari camp to go and experience the wildlife.
How long would you say someone should spend in Africa on a safari?
Well, that's like asking how long's a piece of string, really. I would say that if you've got a good couple of weeks, that'd be nice. We can do 10 days. A typical safari involves moving from camp to camp, and they can be both accommodated in tents or they can be in more hotel lodging type style accommodation. But you really need to, like, for example, and the thing that people don't realize is the size of Africa. I mean, do you realize that in that shape of Africa, you can put the whole of China, the USA,
You know what? You were a little late, and I'm so sorry. They're cutting us off. So can you come back?
I'm so sorry about that.
I'll have you back another night, I promise. Thank you so much, though. You were terrific today, too.
Thanks, Jeff. All right, we're going to have to sign off here, but thanks to all of our guests, Barry Goldstein, Jennifer Fernandez, and Jeff Adam, and thanks, of course, to my co-hosts, Jess Frank and Jerry Augustine. You can contact Jess at 561-213-8579 or jessfrankgolf.com, and Jerry at 561-310-9337 or cdreamstravel.com. Tune in next week and find out all about all three of our travels up to the PGA Merchandise Show in Orlando. And we'll tell you all about it. Have a great week.
You have been listening to the Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Shoup. Heard live every Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 1470 WWNN, and replayed every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. on 740 a.m. WSBR. Visit the show on Facebook and tune in next week. If you are in South Florida or traveling the world, hit them straight. The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of the station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Shoot. Talk 1470, WWNN Pompano Beach, WKIS HD3, Boca Raton, Miami, Fort Lauderdale. Talk health, talk wealth, talk politics. Talk 1470, WNN.
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.